Good evening, students. I hope you are watching these videos on regular basis and you are doing your studies sincerely. I hope you are well and safe wherever you are. So after that, students, there are two case studies. One story is based on Sakal, who went to school. And another story is based on Vilas, who did not go to the school. So you have to read these two case studies yourself first. Story of Vilas here, and on the other page there is Sakal's story. So you have to read these stories yourself, and after that there is a conclusion of these two stories which I am reading now. So in the two case studies we saw Sakal went to school and Vilas did not go. Sakal was physically strong and healthy. So Sakal went to school and he was physically strong and healthy also. There was no need for him to visit the doctor frequently. Vilas was a patient of arthritis. Students, here arthritis means joint pain. Usually occurred in the old age, but Vilas was a patient of this type of disease. He lacked the means to visit the doctor. Sakal acquired a degree in computer programming. Sakal found a job in a private firm while Vilas continued with the same work as his mother. So, what is the difference between these two stories now? Sakal went to school at that time, and after that he acquired a degree in computer programming and found a job in a private firm, while Vilas didn't go to school at that time and continued with the same work as his mother was done. He earned a meagre income like his mother to support a family. So he earned a very little income like his mother to support a family. In the case of Sakal, several years of education added to the quality of labor. This enhances his total productivity. Total productivity adds to the growth of the economy. So here is student Sakal, who went to the school at that time. He spent several years to their education, which added to the quality of his labor. And this enhanced his total productivity, and total productivity adds to the growth of the economy. Now he could produce more because he had spent money in his education and health and training program. That's why his total productivity has increased, and this total productivity leads to the growth of the economy. This in turn pays an individual through salary or in some other form of his choice. So whatever Sakal has gained in his education, in turn of this, he is earning a lot of income in the form of salary or in other some form of his choice. But in case of Vilas, there could not be any education or health care in the early part of his life. He spends his life selling fish like his mother. Henceforth, he draws the same salary of unskilled labor as his mother. So students, here in case of Vilas, he didn't go to the school. That's why he could not having any education or health care facility in the early life. And he spends his life only in selling fish like his mother was. So that's why he draws only a very little amount of money as his mother was earned, because he was an unskilled labor as his mother. Investment in human resource via education and medical care can give high rates of return in the future. So here it is proved that when you will invest in human resource, that is education and medical care, it will give you high rates of return in the future. This investment on pupil is the same as investment in land and capital. As you invest in land and capital, and in turn of this investment, it will provide greater amount of money in your future. Just like that, you will invest in human resource or education and medical care. It will definitely provide you greater income in your future also. One invests in shares and bonds expecting higher return in the future. So everyone who invests in some kind of things like shares, bonds, land, capital, whatever. So what they are expected? They are expected that they will get a higher return in the future. That's why they invested in such kinds of things. So just like that, we also invested in education, training and medical. Why? Because in future to get higher income. A child too with investments made on her education and health can yield a high return in the future in the form of higher earnings and greater contribution to society. So student, just like investment in capital and land, we expected higher returns, higher earnings in the future. Just like that, a child also with investments made on her education and health can yield a high return in the future in the form of higher earnings and greater contribution to the society. Educated parents are found to invest more heavily on the education of their child. This is because they have realized the importance of education for themselves. Students here, just like your parents who are very conscious about your studies, who are very devoted to your performance in the class tests or your class series. So they are conscious about you. Why? Because they are educated and they have realized the importance of education for you. That's why they always concern about your studies. This is because they have realized. They are also conscious of proper nutrition and hygiene also. Students here, just like your parents who are very conscious about your health and hygiene, they usually ask to you, eat this, do not eat this, do not drink this, just like, why? Why they ask to you such type of things? Because they are concerned about your health and hygiene. They are also conscious your proper nutrition, about your proper nutrition and hygiene. That's why they ask to you just things. They accordingly look after their children's needs for education at school and good health. A virtuous cycle is thus created in this case. In contrast, a vicious cycle may be created by disadvantageous parents who themselves uneducated and lacking in hygiene keep their children in a similarly disadvantageous state. So students here, those parents who are not educated, who are not having good hygienic environment themselves, so oppositely to the first case, these kinds of parents keep their children in a similarly disadvantageous state. They are not able to provide better education to their children because their income is very little. That's why they are not able to provide better education to their children and keep their children in a same type of situation as they have.